So the last thing we want to look at is our server controls. We're going to say 5.11. So your server has a lot of the same controls as your layers. There's color control, there's rotate, there's scale. But keep in mind that these will master all of the layers that are associated with that pixel map. So if you want to make a global change across multiple layers, come to your server. There is one parameter that is specific to the server in your intensity area, and that is called your crossfade. You can still control your channels via the desk channels. So my LEDs in this show file are channels 301 through 417. If both desk channels and the pixel map are talking to those addresses, the console needs to know who has priority at any given moment. So the first thing I'm going to do is put 301 through 417 at full. And I'm actually going to put them in green for this example. So as you can see, between the green that I'm feeding it through the desk channel and the content that's coming from the pixel map, I have a highest takes precedence per LED. If I grab my server channel again, as I move crossfade to positive 100, you'll notice that my media server fades out and my desk channels take priority. As I move crossfade down past 0 to negative 100, the media server wins control of the channels and the desk channel levels are suppressed. When crossfade is at its home value, which is 0, it is highest takes precedence for each emitter. Crossfade is a great way to go from a static look recorded into a queue and in and out of media-controlled content. Thanks for joining us for a quick overview of the virtual media server feature in the EOS family system. For a more comprehensive look, please check out the companion workbook to the series, and as always, check out your manual.